So what we're going to do is we're going to look at the 2017 Vans Warped Tour lineup. That has been announced this week. We're going to go through it stage by stage, and I'm going to ask you what stands out for you and what doesn't.
Right.
All right?
Okay.
Right. Fine. So we start, and it's a very, I'll tell you, it's a very interesting look this year, Warped Tour. It's different. They've tried some things that are very surprising. I got read this lineup a couple of weeks ago, and when I was being read it, I was like, "You are fucking kidding! Wow!" To a bunch of these bands, way out of left field. Yeah. So, that without further ado, though, let's get on with it. Right, Journey's Left Foot stage first. That will feature Attila, CKY, Bowling for Soup, Futuristic, Hawthorne Heights, I Prevail, Julie Vera, New Year's Day, Never Shout Never with a throwback set. He's the whiny bitch bloke from the No Room for Rockstars film, if you've ever seen that. Sammy Adams and Watsky. Does anything stand out on that stage for you, mate?
Just at how sort of generally not very good it is. That stands out. Attila, I'm terrible. I think Bowling for Soup are terrible. Hawthorne Heights are terrible. New Year's Day are terrible. That Watsky guy was the one who jumped off of the stage, wasn't he, at Warped Tour a few years ago. Like, not even a proper stage dive, just feet first into a girl's face. So that's pretty shit. And the CKY, I'm not a fan of, although I'm not going to say they're terrible. And I haven't really heard the rest of them, to be honest. So I don't know.
All right. Well, I'm very excited to see CKY. I've not seen them for years. And as we discussed on last week's album club, I like when they're at their best, when they're firing on all cylinders. I think they're a hell of a band. Hawthorne Heights was fucking bizarre, man. I thought that they'd gone back under the rock that they crawled out from, which I would actually like to see. I Prevail at the moment, just so you know, are the standout band in terms of popularity from the heavier end of Warped Tour. By that I mean the like warped core moshy type bands. Uh-huh. So there's a lot of buzz around them, but yeah, that stage in particular doesn't do much for me. So we move on to the Hard Rock stage, and this is probably the biggest talking point of 2017's Warped Tour lineup, when this stage has the Adolescents, the Alarm, Anti-Flag, the Ataris, Bad Cop, the Dickies, Dull Skin, Fire from the Gods, Municipal Waste, Sick of It All, doing the whole run, man, Strung Out, The Suicide Machines, TSOL, and Valiant Thor. Steve, now I'm gonna say what I think about this first, because there was a lot of people going, like younger people going, who are these bands? What are they doing here? Used to look at Warped Tour every single year and be like, wow, I want to go to that. And luckily enough, with my job, I got to go a whole bunch of times. But the thing that really stands out about the last couple of years is that I think Warped Tour, and this might be a lot to do with my age maybe, but Warped Tour has been really flat, I think, for the last couple of years. I haven't looked at it and gone, wow, I want to be part of that. I think that also in recent years, I think credibility has been an issue. For the first time ever, it felt to me like people were en masse sneering at Warped Tour, like, oh, if you're not a kid who likes Pierce the Veil and that kind of thing, then you're not welcome at Warped Tour. What all of these bands are, just in case you don't know about these bands, they are all old school Warped Tour alumni in various guises. Steve, do you think that this is at least if you're our age, because there's stuff here for us and there's stuff here for people, I would say, a couple of years slightly younger than myself, so stuff like the Ataris.
Yeah.
What is your reaction to this stage, mate, and what it brings to Warped Tour?
There is stuff here for people older than me. I mean, the adolescents split up when I was two. Do you know what I mean?
TSOL?
Yeah.
Jesus, man.
You know, the Dickies, like...
the Dickies were old in the late 90s.
Yeah. I mean, you know, Strung Out have been around for ages. I mean, Sick of It All. I mean, that's the thing. If you think like the people talking about, you know, I go to Warped Tour and it's punk rock and da da da, but oh, this lineup's shit. I mean, if you think you've got anything to do with punk and you don't have any respect for TSOL or the Adolescents or Sick of It All, then that's insanity. For me, speaking as an old fucker, like, I guess, that's a great lineup, that stage. Like, that's great. But I would say that, wouldn't I? Do you know what I mean?
Here's what I wanted to ask you. So if this Warped Tour, this whole lineup came to the UK, for example, this was like a Saturday afternoon in the sun, wherever in the UK, would that stage be enough to make you buy a ticket?
In a heartbeat.
This is what I think. Mm. This is what I think too.
I would love to see the Adolescents. I would love to see Sick of It All, Municipal Waste, TSOL, Valiant Thor. I saw a few weeks ago supporting Trivium. I thought they were really good as well. I used to quite like the Ataris. I think Anti-Flag, not as much, but like in general, that's strong. For me, that's really strong.
It's really strong. And to see someone like Municipal Waste on that lineup is great. I mean, the Ataris are classic Warped Tour in the sun music. And I think it's kind of cool that they've got Fire from the Gods on there. Because Fire from the Gods are a band that are currently blowing up like satellite radio out here. They're very made for US radio, like heavier, like quote unquote metal act. But it's cool to have that on there as well. But yeah, I'm of a similar view. So like, if you are looking at it and sneering, you have to remember that there's a whole bunch of people, there's a whole generation of people that might go out now and buy a Warped Tour ticket. And you got to remember that there is also parents to think of here. Like, if you like people our age generally have kids that might be fucking of the age now that they want to go to Warped Tour. Mm. And this will make the parent be like, well, all right, I'll take you to Warped Tour because I can go and watch the Adolescents, or I can go and watch the Dickies or Municipal Waste or Sick of It All or whoever. Like, it makes it a little bit more appealing to the parent. So I do understand why this stage has been booked. And like, we ain't done yet with the old school bands. Mm. There's a couple more to come. All right. Skull Candy stage. Steve's favourite band in the entire world, Aylstorm.
Hold on. I prefer Sabaton to Aylstorm.
I was about to say, he likes Starbars and Aylstorm. Bad Seed Rising, Barbed Wire Dolls, Big D and the Kids Table, Microwave, Riverboat Gamblers, Sonic Boom 6, Stacked Like Pancakes, The Street Dogs, Twilight Creeps, War on Women, The White Noise, and William Control. Anything stand out on there for you?
I've heard good shit about War on Women.
They are a good band, but we'll do a, you know what we did before?
Yeah.
When we picked bands that people don't really know about. Mm-hmm. We'll do that the week before Warped Tour starts, and I guarantee that'll be part of
it. Yeah, okay, cool. Apart from that, they're either bands I don't really know about or slightly older bands that I don't like. Big D and the Kids Table were kind of, I was never really into them, but again, they're a bit more of a heritage-y thing, aren't they? William Control, that's the dude from Aiden's solo shit, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
I wish people could have seen your face. I must apologise. We were going to have YouTube back this week, but we were waiting on some equipment that didn't show up, and we could have done it, but it wouldn't have looked as good as I want it to. And because people were digging me out on Twitter going, oh, it's not going to look as good as it did. You're going to have to wait an extra week for us to be back on YouTube in the way that we would like to be. But sorry. Carry on.
I think Sonic Boom 6 are terrible and Aylstorm are terrible. Like Aylstorm, it's harsh on Sonic Boom 6 to say they're terrible right next to Aylstorm, because Aylstorm are a whole new level of terrible. Like Sonic Boom 6 are like, you know, sort of a crash on the M5, like a couple of cars crashed on the M5, whereas Aylstorm are like 9/11. So
fucking hell. Do you know what, man? Like, I really liked Sonic Boom 6 had a self-titled record in 2012 that I was super into. Mm. So I'm going to give slight props to Sonic Boom 6. Also on that stage, Microwave are one of the bands that we will cover in that special as well, who I think that you'll really dig.
Okay.
But we'll come back to that in a couple of weeks' time, because the full sale stage is Bad Omens, Boston Manor, Carousel Kings, Courage My Love, Creeper, The Dukes, Eternal Boy, The Fantastic Plastics, Farewell Winters, Feaky, The Gospel Youth, Knocked Loose, Montage, Movements, Naked Walrus, One Last Shot, Playboy Man Baby, Sarah and the Safe Word, Separation, Shattered Sun, Tilly, Trophy Eyes, and The Waves. Of course, there are some bands that dip in and out of Warped Tour on different dates, so that's just the whole summer. All of those bands are going to be appearing at various different times. Anything on there?
I'd like to see Knocked Loose, as there's so much, hype around them. I think Boston Manor I'd like to see as well. I've never seen them before. They're kind of two that we've reviewed. Again, I don't really know many of... I've heard the name Shattered Sun, but I don't really know if that's just because they sound like every other band's name. and then there's that band Creeper, who we'll probably talk about a bit later. So
yeah, we've got something. We've got a couple of things to say about them, haven't we? Let's save that for a bit. But yeah, Creeper are the standout, and as you quite rightly said, I'm quite into seeing Knocked Loose as well, because we were both quite lukewarm about the album, but other people fucking love it. Mm. And everyone who I've spoken to who've seen them live have said that they are fantastic live, so I do look forward to seeing that. Right, let's get on with the heavy shit then. The Monster Mutant North Stage. That's a mouthful. The Acacia Strain, Being as an Ocean, Canderia, Counterparts, Fit for a King, Hatebreed, Silent Planet, Stick to Your Guns, and Sylar. I am telling you this for nothing now. I'm gonna go to the Vegas date of Warped Tour, because the last date of Warped Tour is Los Angeles, so we're gonna have to, like, we can't review Warped on the last date, so I'm gonna head to Vegas for it. As soon as Destroy Everything starts, I'm gonna kick someone with a wife beater and a bad haircut into the surface of the sun.
Good for you, as well you should. Yeah, that's a strong lineup. Canderia are the ones that stand out completely for me. Like, that's mental. Canderia,
way out of left field,
and they are fucking awesome, that band. Their last album, I think we didn't even review it, actually, funnily enough, but at the end of the year, that was one where I was like, shit, we really should have reviewed that, because mate, 300% Density from 2001, if you're looking for some techie metal from the past, get the fuck on that, because that is a great band. I think Being as an Ocean, I think I've heard, and they're all right as well.
They're British, yeah.
Yeah, they're all right.
Stick to your guns, mate.
Stick to your guns, ovs. Yeah.
Always big live, and like, they are totally dependable. But yeah, a very exciting look. I think that outside of us two being quite old and going, yeah, old bands, I think that they've really done well with the heavy stuff, as we will discuss now with the Monster Mutant South Stage. So two stages of like Warped Tour level heaviness. After the Burial, Bless the Fall, Carnifex, Immure, Guar, 100th, Silverstein, Sworn In, and Too Close to Touch. What's your take on that?
I think Carnifex are fucking great live. I saw them on the Electric Ballroom at the end of last year, you know, really giving Whitechapel and Thy Art Is Murder a C&2. They were the best band on whatever that fucking tour was called. So they're really good live. And I think After the Burial are pretty good live as well. Apart from that, I really hate Bless the Fall, as you can probably remember. I think they're rubbish. And Sworn In, I think, were kind of another one that I was like...
Yeah, they are absolute cack, Steve.
Yeah. Yes. And Silverstein are crap as well, aren't they? So
I'm not a fan either. I think that After the Burial threatened to be a great band once upon a time, and they are definitely, if I'm going to watch one of the like warped core heavy bands, they are one of the better ones of them without question. I'm intrigued to see the new lineup of Immure as well. I have to say that album sold really well, and I liked it way more than I thought I was going to. So I'm going to give them a watch. But yeah, Gwar being on Warped Tour is fucking mental.
Yeah, that's lunacy.
Absolutely
isn't it?
Mental. Like, I like the fact that that something like there is different and is going to stand out that much. Do you know what I mean? If you're a kid that that has never even heard of Gwar before, and you walk past the stage and that is going on, it's going to catch your attention. I think that's a really cool thing. Again, I just think that Warped Tour had kind of fallen into this this thing where everyone just kind of went, oh, it's all those pissy Hot Topic bands, and Gwar is one of the bands that really makes you go, oh really, is it? I just think that this year has really made you reassess what Warped Tour is, and I think that's a positive thing, because it was starting to go a little bit stale. And the final stage is Journey's Right Foot, and it's American Authors, Andy Black, Beartooth, Dance Gavin Dance, Goldfinger, Hands Like Houses, Memphis May Fire, Neck Deep, Our Last Night, Save Ferris, and Streetlight Manifesto.
Save Ferris? How funny.
Like, can you imagine? You can well imagine how much I like Save Ferris, can't you?
I bet you love Save Ferris, don't you?
I'm absolutely gutted. They're playing LA this Sunday, but it's the same day as Biffy Clyro, so I've got to miss it. So I'm well stoked that they're on Warped Tour.
Right. Good for Neck Deep. Good for Beartooth. I love that first Goldfinger album. But not much else, if I'm being perfectly honest. I've not listened to the Andy Black records since it came out, but I'd be interested to see what that was like live.
I think it's very interesting that it's Andy Black and not Black Veil Brides, because we heard all this that Black Veil Brides were in the studio at the beginning of the year, and that's gone quiet, and now Andy Black is going out on Warped Tour.
Yeah.
And the album definitely didn't do what they were hoping it was going to, the Andy Black record. So that's a very interesting set of circumstances. I would like to find out what the fuck's going on with Black Veil Brides, because they were on the cover of AP at the beginning of the year as well, out here. So really, like, that's very, very odd that Black Veil Brides seem to have gone quiet and there's an Andy Black record that's dropped. I would say as well that of all of the modern era bands, Neck Deep is definitely the standout band of these whole tours, and we're expecting a new album this summer. I say we're expecting a new album this summer because I saw them at Architects on Saturday night, which we'll be talking about a little bit later on in the show. So yeah, so you would buy a Warped Tour ticket off the back of that?
Yeah, I think I would. I mean, you know, you can't have everything, can you? So obviously, I'd probably have to, you know, when Memphis Mayfire on, you go and get something to eat or whatever. You can't expect the whole thing to be brilliant. I think people have to have a realistic... Like, for me, there is, just scrolling past it quickly now, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7...
Chat amongst yourself, everyone.
8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. There's like 20 bands. There's like 20 bands out of that lineup that I would want to like actively be gutted to not see.
Yeah, well that's my take. I think that it's a very different but very welcome sea change for Warped Tour. But what we want to know is, we want to hear from you guys. If you are a younger person that is interested in Warped Tour music, let us know what you think of it, because ultimately you are the target demographic more than Steve and I. So we'd like to hear what you think of the Warped Tour lineup at Not Metal Pod on Twitter. And if you're on YouTube and you're listening to this particular section of it, check out the comments below, talk to us and let us know what you think of the Warped Tour lineup this year. Very interesting stuff.